As you can see, with the we were handle of the prostas and the pepper sprays everywhere. We have idea maybe to tomorrow try to hitchhike the ride and skip the last 2 days of cycling and just leave Sudan as soon as possible before Sudan reached the red list of Kenya. We don't want to sit 2 weeks in a hotel in Kenya. So, yeah.
Khartoum.
Khartoum. The video. Video.
Travel video.
Travel. Mumajir live. Live.
Live.
Live.
No, no, no.
No.
This is camera.
I was thinking this officer gonna break my balls for filming at the police checkpoint, but he was really friendly. Yeah, we are closing to pyramids. Should be in 1 hour or less. So maybe it's gonna be yeah, we should reach on time on our siesta time. It's gonna be a perfect spot there. Wondering how much how hot is here. Yesterday we were checking the weathercast, so it's 35 today Celsius, and tomorrow and next couple of days around Khartoum is 37, so it's a bit hotter than in the north. In the north was around 30 degrees Celsius. So yeah, you can really feel those 5 degrees. Shit. Oh man, that sucks. It looks a recent crash, because the guys is yeah, it looks like it's a recently. Look at this guy, what he's doing. I mean, what the fuck? Oh man, I mean, it's just ridiculous. These bus drivers are the most craziest. They like so speeding. 45 speed. Really nice downhill. I don't know, Patrick, why so slow? Go, chap chap, Patrick. know how these goat keepers, or how do you call them, how stupid they are. I mean, sorry for the word, but they keep these goats along this crazy busy highway. And in last couple of hours, I already saw two roadkills, goats, two dead goats on the road. I mean, I don't get it. I mean, why? Maybe they are just free here and they are wandering around eating garbage, but still. On the side, no?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. These goats are smart, they're just chilling under the bush, eating some grass, sand. But yeah. Oh.
Oh, my friend!
For both of us?
Mm.
Let's try a fight.
Very nice.
Hello, hello.
The mom.
Do you meet a lot of tourists?
Here.
No need.
Small.
You see big bags, no space.
Oh, not big, this is small. Eh?
No, no, still long way to go.
This is small, not big.
Long way to go.
Very nice.
Sorry.
This is nice.
Thank you, thank you. This is nice also, but sorry, man. Yeah, so apparently this not the entrance from the main road. We need to go all around behind somewhere that dunes. I have no idea how long it is, but looks far enough. Let's see. Especially pushing through the sand. Loaded bicycles on this heat. It's not fun, not fun at all. Pyramids. is the most famous pyramids of Sudan. 2500 years BC, the first pyramid was built. It's a Nubian pyramids. I think Sudan has the biggest number of pyramids in the world. I think it's like 250 or something. I mean, yeah, they're really cool actually. But the best part is that me and Patrick is the only people in this huge desert area. So yeah, we have all pyramids only for ourselves, so it's pretty cool. It's an amazing place and we are really lucky to be here alone. It's just something unbelievable. I still cannot believe it. We cycle with, because of this, with the 3 days detour. It's really
camera.
What is?
That is Sudani.
Crania, give one Sudani.
You need Sudani.
That's Russian.
Yes, you need Sudani.
This I don't need.
You need friend?
No, it's a Russian money. Why we?
Yes.
We don't need. It's...
Friend, you wife or not wife?
Wife? Yeah. How much you say wife?
No.
5,000?
From Sudan?
Yeah.
From Sudan and the Sudan. Not coin, yes? Not money.
Not money.
And the Sudan for the Sudan, your wife. And this is in Quran and the people Sudan, you. For the people.
Yeah.
Wife.
This one.
Yeah.
Life. Oh, okay. 1,000 in Sudan, you. Yes, your wife. For mama, your wife.
Ah, okay.
In Sudan, not money.
Yeah.
For people, my wife.
Community.
Yeah, in the back.
Yeah.
Your UFO.
Okay.
For gold, for sandal and the bar phone.
Okay.
In Sudan.
How old is the woman?
No. 20 years.
20 years.
90 years.
8 years.
19.
15 is too young.
Yeah, very good. 15,
not
50. Yes, sir. 15. Yes. Hello. 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 Hello.
I don't know.
No money?
If you have a nice car, it's easy. I'm joking. I don't know. There is no price for women in Lithuania.
No money. For gift, for the friend, friendy is gold. Your wife, yes?
Gold.
Oh.
Gold. A lot of gold.
No. The Sudan is gold.
Gold?
Yes. Yeah. Sudan for gold, your wife gift.
Okay.
Yes.
Can we try to just go there and see if they leave for
us? Yeah, we need to try.
They leave, we should stay inside.
Good morning, guys. It was a tough night, actually. Strong wind was shaking my tent all night, and somehow I have no idea how, but it blew the sand inside the tent for some time. I feel everywhere is sand on me, on my face, everywhere. Didn't get much sleep. So yeah, like I mentioned yesterday, you can see my flip-flops are covered in the sand. Yeah, so how I mentioned yesterday, we're gonna hitchhike a ride because yeah, we don't wanna be stuck in Kenya in a quarantine. It's just or even worst case would be stuck in Sudan. So yeah, it's not an option for us. Also, there is a second reason why we want to leave Sudan as soon as possible. And this road is really not safe. The vehicles are so crazy here. Yesterday I was twice pushed into a ditch, and it's still 2 days left, and the bus drivers are just crazy fast, and they're passing so close to you. So yeah, the first thing is safety for us, also enjoying the trip and the day. And I don't think we enjoying this road much, at least I don't. So yeah, but yeah, we need to leave Sudan as soon as possible and hopefully reach Kenya without any hassle and without any quarantines. And yeah, so
yeah, so we at the gas station. Is it Port Sudan?
Yeah, we tried. It's a Port Sudan.
What?
Port Sudan.
Port Sudan.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's quite short stop from Atbara. I mean,
it's 200 kilometers.
Yeah, no, but I was thinking from Atbara to here, but
still
100. Yeah, it's
100. Yeah, so we're at the gas station, trying to hitchhike the ride or find the bus. Let's see how it's gonna go. Let's see how hitchhiking in Sudan. We stopped this car.
Yeah.
Let's see if he goes to Khartoum. So this guy is insane. He just said 30,000. Is it like 60 euros for 200 kilometers? Yeah, so 3 cars so far stop, and they all want money. I would say maybe they don't know the concept of the hitchhiking, and maybe there is no such a thing like free ride in Sudan. Yeah, I would say let's try and hitchhike because we have all the time we need, but in this case we don't have any time, so I guess we need to try give some money.
It's way too small.
My house too. The guy tried to put to fit 2 bikes in that space. I mean, it's really nice that he tried, but so So yeah, after 3 hours of waiting on the road, we find one guy. We pay him $10, but he's a really nice guy. He bought us some water and some meat. So we had some liver, some meat, some food, some hops, bread, water, Coca-Cola, and chai is coming with some desserts. And this man is a legend. Yeah, so we have some problems with transmission. After 1 hour of driving, still have 150 to go, so we can drive only 50 kilometers per hour, so I hope he can fix it. Ali, very nice man, helped us reach Khartoum. You can see what we were handle of the process, and the pepper spray is everywhere. I'm gonna sit here, you know, they're gonna see a tourist in a friend, it's not gonna be a good idea.
No camera.
Yeah.
Yeah, so just we tried to leave the hotel, and we were caught up in the middle of the protest. There was some smoke bombs or tear gas, and yeah, there is some roadblocks now, and you can see there is a lot of people, and
there is a roadblock as well.
This is easy.
Oh yeah.
Super tiny cap, and we put our two huge bicycle box on the top. And it doesn't look really secure because we didn't have a lot of time to secure it. We just need to put it fast, and because there was a tear gas everywhere, and the taxi driver feel very weak, so he There is a roadblock everywhere. Every road is blocked, I don't know. Yeah, you can feel it.
can you close the window? The window.
Huh?
The window is closed. It's coming, the gas.
Okay.
Yeah, you can feel the gas everywhere and smoke is... Yeah, the airport is only 3 kilometers, 3 and a bit kilometers away. It's like 15 minutes drive, and we just, if we left 30 minutes before, it would be less. And yeah, we see a military pickup in front of us, so I guess I need to turn up the camera now. Just close to us. Fuck. Till this moment, it was like recycling. Everything was perfect. We didn't feel any presence of the military or a coup whatsoever. And yeah, only last day when we need to leave to the Kenya is happening. It's always like this.
Man.
What do you think, Patrick?
Yeah, I mean, we were right in the like the center of all the smoke, and we're still not out of it, I guess.
Yeah, I think, as you can see.
I mean, my I have tear gas in my eyes.
Yeah, we both are tears from our eyes, and let's see. It looks like here is much better,
yeah.
So...